my absolute favorite type of books that you gotta read. As they neared the home straight, Bannister marshaled his remaining kick. This was his final chance. This was the point in the race he and Stamp had decided Landy would never anticipate. This was the strike he had practiced with Chatterway. Bannister needed to win. He had to win. The Australian could run as an expression of the best that was within him, but Bannister ran to be better than anyone else. This was the moment to reveal that he was. 90 yards from the tape, Bannister swung his arms high and lengthened his stride. He urged his tired muscles into action. The effort took every shred of will and heart he had left. When he passed Landy, he wanted to do it so fast. Coming out of the bend, Landy thought he had finally shaken Bannister. He could no longer see Bannister's shadow. Good thing, since Landy knew that he had no more strength in his legs. He looked over his left shoulder to make sure he had succeeded. Exactly at that moment, Bannister hurled himself around Landy on the right in two long strides, seeing the Australian glance the other way and knowing that that hesitation would cost him, if only the smallest fraction of a second. At 70 yards of the tape, Bannister seized the lead. It was exhilaration. It was triumph. Although excruciatingly painful to keep his feet, this was the moment he loved most in running, the moment when his spirit fused with the physical act of running. The roar of the crowd pushed him onward. Everything was a blur by the finish line. He sped down the track, momentum carrying him down. Landy tried to kick down the home stretch, but knew his legs were finished. The English miler sprinted to the finish, his long stride unfailing. With a last drive of his right foot, he leapt forward, head back in sheer exultation. He broke through the tape, victory his at last. That is a passage from an absolutely amazing book called The Perfect Mile. It is by Neal Bascomb, written in 2004. And what the book is about is it's set in, call it, the 1930s and 1950s. And it covers three continents and focuses on three men: Roger Bannister, John Landy, and Wes Santee. And these are the three men who in the 1950s were chasing what at the time was considered an impossible athletic feat, breaking 4 minutes in the mile. And this book covers how Roger Bannister eventually broke that mile. And then the passage I read covers the Commonwealth game between within the British Empire when Roger Bannister and John Landy, who had both at that time broken the 4 minute mile, for the first time ran head to head in that race. And it's considered the perfect mile because it was such an amazing race where Roger Bannister inked ahead at the very end, but both men ended up finishing under 4 miles. These are my favorite type of books to read. They're my favorite type of books, meaning that I love histories. I love histories about running. My second favorite type of books are a subset of that, which are biographies. What I would consider doing was reading this book as a book about character. And in particular, the character of the second protagonist in the story, who is John Landy. John Landy is the Australian who was chasing the 4 minute barrier, who ultimately did not break it first. Roger Bannister did, but did break it subsequently. But as you read through the whole course of the book, you learn a lot about this individual and how this individual lived his life and how running was a component, but not all the elements of his life. In the words of the author, John Landy lately succinctly characterized his loss to Vancouver. It was the race I had to win, but I didn't. Directly after the race, he was the consummate gentleman, praising Bannister for a terrific run and telling the press that the better man had won. A day later, he told the press that he accepted a teaching job at Geelong Grammar School and that his future as a miler was hazy. But this announcement was drowned out by the report that his foot had been cut prior to the race and they had said nothing about it. "Did you stand on a flashbulb on Thursday?" "How do you know if I stepped on the flashbulb?" Landy said. "All I'm saying is that I went to the mile start 100% fit. Landy moved away, favoring his right leg over his left. Are you sure that limp isn't due to a cut? The correspondent stopped him. If I could run a 3:59 with a limp, Landy said, I've got possibilities as a runner. So what he's talking about here is in that race that I read at the very beginning in Vancouver in the Commonwealth Games, it turns out that a few days before the event took place, John Landy actually stepped on a piece of glass and cut his foot really bad. And didn't tell anyone, got a bandage, got some stitches in there, and ended up running the race with his foot. And when people found this out, immediately they were thinking, wow, this is an excuse, this is the reason why he lost the race. And, you know, that passage talks about how John Landy described it and how he handled the situation. So with that being said, like I mentioned, it's a book you gotta read. But let me end with just one last passage in the book. John Landy says, running gave me discipline and self-expression. It has all the disappointments, frustrations, lack of success, and unexpected success, which all reproduce themselves in the bigger play of life. It teaches you the ability to be present under pressure. It teaches you the importance of being enthusiastic, dedicated, focused. All of these are trite statements, but if you actually have to go through these things as a young man, it's very, very important. Character. Great way to read the book, among the many reasons to check this one out.